Our big headline, a jury has recommended life without parole for Ronnie O'Neill. This comes just days after that same jury found him guilty of killing his girlfriend and 9-year-old daughter with special needs. The family of the victim sat in that courtroom this week as the jury heard arguments and then made their decision this evening. ABC Action News reporter Haley Bull has their reaction tonight.
I am empty without my grandson. I am empty without my granddaughter and my daughter. But at the end of the day, God sits high and he looked low.
The family of Kenyatta Barron and her 9-year-old daughter, Renivia, left the courthouse after the man convicted of murdering them was spared the death penalty.
He took a disabled little child and her mother in the most inhumane way possible, slaughtered them. If you can't tell me that's worth the life, then I kind of lost a little bit of faith in the justice system.
A jury previously found Ronnie O'Neill guilty of murdering his girlfriend and daughter and trying to kill his son. Friday, that same jury deliberated whether he should receive the death penalty. The state worked to show jurors the crimes were especially cruel.
She can't help herself at all. She can't even talk. And this is her dad that's murdering her.
The defense pointed to traumatic events in O'Neill's past and a family history of mental illness.
Ronnie feels like he's under attack. He's up all night. He's paranoid. He's hypervigilant. He believes he was targeted by the shooting.
After deliberating, the jury did not reach a unanimous verdict for the death penalty the state sought, instead recommending life behind bars without parole. An official sentencing is scheduled for next month.
We was wanting for the death penalty. That's true. We didn't get that. But at the end of the day, he's not going to be leaving out of there until he's in a box.
But he's going to be so miserable behind those bars till he's going to wish he was dead, because my children are at peace. They're at peace. And I thank God for that.
But as this family leaves the courthouse, they reflect on their loved ones taken too soon.
Their last moments on earth was per hell. And we was just told that not even that was worth another life. So as far as the closure part goes, we got to go celebrate Ronivia's birthday at her gravesite. Her birthday's next month.
In Tampa, Haley Bull, ABC Action News.